Hello, hello, hello.
The Lord, as we were saying earlier, is always knocking. He's always talking to us. He's always making noises to us. He's always saying hello. He has a way of saying hello in so many different ways, but we have to know and we have to hear. And I'm not talking about hearing. I'm talking about before you can hear, you have to start listening. You have to want to listen. You have to be there. Beware. Wherever the message is being ministered, wherever the message is being preached, you have to be there to be able to listen. But listening isn't good enough. Don't impress me or a brother or a sister or your teacher that you're a good listener sitting there with your books, your pen and your pencil and all your activity, your backpack and all that. You're sitting there and listening? It's not enough. You need to be encouraged. We need to be encouraged. I need to be encouraged. We need to be trained and trained up in the promises and in the strength and the power of God, what God has brought us. You need to hear by listening first. For faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And even in the hearing, we're not going to hear or receive it unless we start listening. And even if you start listening, like a lot of people that come to church, a lot of people that hear the word, a lot of people that go to Bible study, they're sitting down, they're there, their present physical bodies are there, listening. But it's not going in. There's a lot of combination of reasons why it's not going in. Let's give a little bit of exhortation here. A lot of the public is not here right now. A lot of the parents, a lot of the kids are not here right now. But even the kids that are here, they already understand some of this because they get ministered a few of these things in the ministry of learning how to play the guitar. We try to teach them how to pray. We try to teach them how to be more aware. We try to teach them how to respect their parents. We try to teach them right and wrong and wrong and right so that they can know if they step toward the wickedness. They need to know so they can step toward the light, toward the righteousness. And a lot of them still don't know the Lord yet, like some of you. A lot of them don't know Jesus, don't have a relationship yet. Praise God. We'll continue in a few minutes. But before we do, we want to give an acknowledgement to Brother Eric for being with the Something Big organization for about 5 years now. He's one of the guitar teachers, Brother Eric. You're always standing, Brother Eric. Can we have you? Oh, right, there you are. We love you, Brother Eric, because the Lord brought you, and He put you in our life, here, in the class, in the ministry work, wherever you are. You're part of the family. And anybody that's in Jesus, you have a new family name now. It's called Jesus Christ. Don't forget it. Don't forget it. Don't forget it. The word in Romans says, because we are in the Lord and the Lord is ours now, we are the true Jew. We are the true Jew. We have become Jew and Jewish. In Jesus Christ, we have His blood. We have Him. We have His Spirit. We have a relationship. He's our Savior. We've been grafted in because of His goodness, the goodness of the Father. Unless the goodness of the Lord, the mercy, the tender mercies of a living God, unless that manifested for you and for me, I would still be dead in my trespasses. Praise God!